then the prosecution has relied upon that testimony of the child. Firstly, court has to satisfy itself by putting some questions that does he understand, and according to his age and normal course of events, he is in a position to give rational answers after understanding the questions. So he can be a good witness, but that is not normally it is said that the testimony of a child is very risky. But at the same time, if he has undergone the test of cross-examination, but that test of cross-examination shall not be like adult, then the court would regulate what type of questions can be put, enabling that child witness to answer that according to his age. So, but there are some, that is on the one hand, is disability as well, like due to extreme old age. So, although the occurrence had taken place for some 80-90 years old person in his house, let's say any of his loved one was subjected to torture or was killed, or some decay was being committed, or some sort of theft was committed, whatever. But that court has to. So there is no hindrance, or there is no practically no restriction. Likewise, that of the because of any ailment, whether body or mental, but it cannot be, one should not, the court must not sit. If any objection is raised by either of the parties that the witness which is being produced by that very party is an insane person, the court can. That's why it is said that lunatic, because there are some sort of lunacies or mental condition which are possibly like schizophrenic people. So they keep themselves normal, but sometimes they become so violent, rage. So this is terminal. But at that very time when that occurrence had taken place, that was properly and effectively perceived by seeing that, as we have discussed, a state of thing. But whatever was heard or seen or perceived by using any of the senses as relatable to that kind of testimony which is being brought on record, either in civil case or criminal case. So this is, but in some improviso, it has also been provided that a person who has already been convicted for perjury, for deposing in any court as a witness, or he is like a stock witness, he appears in the court and give evidence, habitual of giving evidence on the for some extraneous consideration, which can be in terms of kind, in terms of some financial benefit. So this who may testify, everybody, even irrespective of the age or old age, but if the rational answer can be given. But in the proviso, it has been determined that that person who has already committed, but if it was in some old affair and he has repented, then in the next proviso, it has been clarified that. Or if he has already tendered his repentance, so he feels shame because of this already, whatever was the situation, or even he was in some need of money, which was a genuine, and he had deposed, that's why he had to commit perjury, and that's why. Likewise, the court shall determine the competence of witness according to the qualification of, when the need of promulgation of this new Kanune Shahadat Order 1984 was deemed as appropriate by replacing the earlier Evidence Act, which remained prevalent even after the independence of Pakistan. Certainly, different amendment might have been, but that evidence act. The purpose and objective behind promulgation of this Colonial Charter in 1984 was felt during the regime of General Zia-ul-Haq, who was ruling the country, to bring it in conformity with injunctions of Islam. Was, you know, but that standard is quite different. Was in according to there are some hudud, wali, jaise hum kehte hain ke when somebody has committed any offense and had crossed the limitations ordained by Almighty Allah and according to the Islamic teachings of Quran and traditions of Holy Prophet, that's why there is a severity of very harsh punishment have been provided. Because if, you know, but for proving that kind of offense in accordance with injunctions of Islam, there are very strict principles, guiding principles for evaluation of the evidence. Because if, you know, if the punishment is like a qisas, an eye for an eye, and a hand for a hand, life for a life, you know, if somebody has murdered, you know, the standard to prove that kind of testimony for entailing and applying the punishment prescribed in the Holy Quran, a witness should also be a person of absolutely impeccable character, unimpeachable, you know, and his credibility and his, you know, being a very pious person, then tazkiyat al-shuhud, then he should also undergo the test of being so purified, so yani, noble person, dealt with जो कभी कबीरा गुनाह ना किया हो, कभी परजरी का तो पहले कभी द्रोह कोई ना किया हो, इंजॉयज नॉर्मली इट इज बिकॉज ताजीरी हमारे डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द काजी है, डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द कोर्ट है, तो ताजीर में जैसे इसलिए हम कहते हैं कि जैसे मर्डर में 302 यानी 302 ए वाले केस में, क्योंकि कसास की वाली लेवल की एविडेंस अवेलेबल नहीं होती, तो फिर इसीलिए हम कहते हैं 302 PPC 302 बी पार्ट बी PPC वो एज ए जो कि डेथ अवार्ड की जा सकती है कैपिटल पनिशमेंट, बट दैट वुड बी टर्म टू बी तजीर डिस्क्रिशन ऑफ द काजी, सच लाइक स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ प्रूफ इज नॉट अवेलेबल। बैन इसी तौर पर जो बाकी दीगर जैसे थेफ्ट की बात की है, बर्कली की बात की है, हाउस ब्रेकिंग की बात की है, जिसमें इस्लामी सजाएँ मौजूद हैं, लेकिन वो नहीं तो फिर डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द कोर्ट है। तो आगे ये हमने जजेज एंड मैजिस्ट्रेट्स के हवाले से, अच्छा फिर ये आगे मैं देखा आपने कि जजेज एंड मैजिस्ट्रेट नो जज मैजिस्ट्रेट एक्सेप्ट ऑन द स्पेशल ऑर्डर, तो फ्रॉम आर्टिकल 4 to 18 दीज आर सम प्रिविलेज कम्युनिकेशन, सो देर इज ए यू नो इट हैज बीन पॉस्टुलेटेड QSO that for recording testimony, if in the course of exercises of his judicial powers, a judge or a magistrate, knowing something certainly, because he has to see, it may be possible that otherwise the trial judge is convinced that this accused has committed the murder of somebody for which he had to face the trial, and after the recording of the evidence, but if the evidence maybe he had generally killed, but no legal evidence was produced by the prosecution, so certainly the benefit of doubt shall, that is why it is said to be the beyond reasonable doubt of the common man, of the prudent man, so that is why there are very strict rules. It does not mean that he can be called as a witness because he has ignored this fact. Similarly, some communication, there are different manifestation of privileged communication. Likewise, jazam is communication during marriage. No marriage, no person can be forced and compelled to disclose about their marital relation, because that is a privileged communication between the spouses. Evidence to affairs of state, nobody can be compelled, because you know that is a secret act hai, or to bade serious mamlaat hai, jisme national security involved hai, so, and any policy decision is taken. So that, normally we say the privileged communication pass over record bhi honorable as a missing persons ke matters mein honorable supreme court ne so motor notice mein article 184 जी, तो वो कह रहे थे इन कैमरा कर लें जी, इसमें बड़ी कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी इन्वॉल्व है, बड़ा सीरियस है, तो उसमें स्टेट इंस्टीट्यूशन की के मामला हैं, तो ये दिस इज ऑल्सो ऑफिशियल कम्युनिकेशन जो होती है किसी मामले के हवाले से बिटवीन इंफॉर्मेशन एज टू कमीशन ऑफ ऑफेंसेस प्रोफेशनल कम्युनिकेशन कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन लॉयर एंड एडवोकेट बिकॉज एडवोकेट then has been engaged by his client and during that communication he has come to know about some sort of weaknesses of his client. So it does not mean that he should be called and he should disclose the facts, because this is a privileged communication. He had come to him for seeking professional assistance and for obtaining his services against some fee, but it does not mean that they should. Even a lawyer cannot do anything in furtherance of common intention. But normal in the course mein ho sakta hai. Apply to interpreter, Article 9, apply to interpreter. So when we were discussing who may testify, if through signs and marks, kabhi bahut pehle hum ek program dekha karte the, bolte haath, kafi arsa Pakistan television par, hamara to bachpan ka zamana tha, 80s ka daur hai. तो एक खातून एक बंदा था, शायद वो डेफ एंड डम था, तो वो खबरें पढ़ती यानी कि वो हाथों से करता था, तो वो खातून शायद से इशारों से बताती थी. तो ये अब ऐसी कोई सिचुएशन किसी अदालत में पैदा हो गई है, तो फिर आर्टिकल 9 वाला जो बंदा है तो वो कोई शहादत दे रहा है इंटरप्रेटर, तो वो भी एक तरह की प्रबल कमी आल, तो वो भी ओथ भी होती है. अगर कोई ऐसी सिचुएशन पैदा हो गई है, जैसे कोई बंदा फर्ज करें अदालत में कोई ऐसा विटनेस आया है जो अदालत की वो ज़बान उर्दू या इंग्लिश नहीं समझ रहा, तो सर्टनली वो कोई ऐसी इलाकई ज़बान है जो दूर दराज इलाके की है, किसी बहुत बैकवर्ड इलाके की है, तो फिर द पर्सन वो इज़ कन्वर्सेंट विद दिस लैंग्वेज शैल बी कॉल्ड एज ए विटनेस बींग इंटरप्रेटर एंड वट एवर द क्वेश्चन शैल बी पुट दैट वुड बी कम्युनिकेटेड इन दैट इन हिज ओन लैंग्वेज of that witness which is understandable for that interpreter. इसी तरह जैसे मैंने deaf and dumb की बात की है, तो वो जो उनको समझता है तो वो भी एक तरह की privileged communication है. तो इसकी different manifestation privileged waived by volunteering evidence, confidential communication with legal advisors वाली आ गई, production of documents which in primary possession refused to produce, witness not excused from sitting down, accomplice वाली जो है 337 वाली, जब प्राव पार्डन हम टेंडर करते हैं ना, कि 337 ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर कोड, बिकॉज यू नो वेरी फेमस केस ऑफ लेट ज़ुल्फ़िकार अली भुट्टो, तो ही वाज अवार्डेड डेथ पेनल्टी बाय द देन कोर्ट्स दैट केस ऑफ महमूद कसूरी फादर ऑफ अहमद रज़ा कसूरी आर इनॉल्व्ड बाय दैट वाज ऑन द टेस्टिमनी ऑफ द अकॉम्प्लिस, because the person who had actively participated in that occurrence, so he disclosed this fact because he was Mr. Zulfiqar Bhutto was the instrumental. Later on, anyhow, this is not debatable here, but just for the reference sake, then one of the who later served as the Chief Justice of Supreme Court of Pakistan also admitted this fact on a live on a TV show, that because we were forced to render that verdict. which was originally, anyhow, so that was the case of a company. Ghulam Abbas was probably the then, who was an official of the Federal Security Force. And he disclosed this fact because of the abetment. Rather, they were directed and instigated by then Prime Minister to cause the murder of that Kasuri sir. In this, that cannot be, anyhow, companies cannot be compelled as in this situation. Competence and number of witnesses, this is certainly very important, particularly if it would have been that original evidence, Act of 1872, situation was quite different. But because of the this competence and number of witnesses, because it has been brought in conformity with the injunctions of Islam, therefore I deem it appropriate to read before you the original text of Article 17, heading hai, competence and number of witnesses. The competence of a person to testify and the number of witnesses required in any case shall be determined in accordance with the injunction of Islam as laid down in the Holy Quran Sunnah. Unless otherwise provided in any law related to the enforcement of hudud or any other special law. In matter we have already discussed pertaining to qisas. In matter pertaining to financial feasibility, if reduced to writing, the instrument shall be tied by two men or one man and two women, so that one may remind the other if necessary and evidence shall be led accordingly. Or even in according to the Quranic injunction, different ayat and surahs, it has been specifically referred that I have given reference of some Quranic injunction or ahkamat in my last lecture of introduction, but just for the sake of repetition, even if some document is being got executed by the parties, that should have been the premise of should be attested to some margin witness, let's say agreement to sell. If two men are not available, then one man and two women, so that one may remind the other if necessary and evidence shall be led accordingly. Wo ek maine ayat ka hawala us last lecture mein kab suna ki tumhe diya bhi hai ki ek aurat ki uski short memory hoti hai, agar bhool jaye to phir iske liye ye ek ehtiyat barti gayi hai Islam ke mutabik Qurani ki injunction hai, usse to hum dikhe na khuda na khasa deny nahi kar sakte. In all other matters, the court may accept or act on the testimony of one man or one woman or such other evidence as this. एक और बड़ा प्रिंसिपल है जो आपको ध्यान में रखना है कि चाहे ये खासतौर पर जो क्रिमिनल केसेस में है, देखें इवन द सोल टेस्टिमनी ऑफ अ विटनेस, अ पर्सन एन अक्यूज कैन बी कन्विक्टेड. क्वांटिटी डज नॉट मैटर, क्वालिटी ऑफ द विटनेस मैटर्स. If that the sole statement of it, normally it happens in matters of rape, victim girl or prosecutrix, if none else has seen, but the occurrence, but she and medical, through medical test and medical evidence, her testimony has also been corroborated, but not that this is an arena of DNA. If somebody has committed, and even a lady has conceived because of that act of forcible zina, that then she has given birth to a child, that can be proved. And even by taking the sperm of the man from the ovary of the lady, semen and that sperm, that it can be determined who is the real culprit. In addition to the oral testimony of that victim, through which she is prosecuting an accused person and has placed reliance on her whole, her own sole testimony, as well as through the evidence, a person can be convicted. Sometime maybe in the other way. But as far as the Islamic, if to attract the Islamic mode of punishment, then that is very four male persons have seen the occurrence. But in the nowadays, in this scenario, that things do that punishment, that neither that kind of high quality testimony is available, and rather not possible, nor that can be neither available nor that cannot be proved. So then this is as per discretion of the court, but it does not mean Northern, that's why section 376 deals with the offenses of zina and so forth, so on, as provided in the Pakistan Penal Code. So this is the threshold procedure. Financial future mein rahe, maine do evidence ki baat kar di hai. Competence and number of witnesses, except wo jo maine batayi hai Holy Quran mein jo usne postulated hai, to usme jo tarika kar waza kiya tashkiyat al shuhada wala aur number of witnesses wala, otherwise normal course mein ye aisa nahi hai. Aage hum aa jate hain ji, evidence may be given of fact. Ye chapter 3 deals with the ek hai fact in issue which we have discussed, और वो दोनों की एक आइडेंटिकल जैसे स्टेजेस हैं एज फार एज सिविल केसेस आर कंसर्न. बाय फ्रेमिंग ऑफ द इश्यूज देन द प्रोसेस ऑफ समनिंग द एंड प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द एविडेंस एंड विच वुड बी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द एविडेंस ऑफ द प्लेंटिफ. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन अ सिविल सूट हु हैज टू स्टार्ट द एविडेंस, दैट वुड बी firstly of the plaintiff who has instituted the suit, whereas for rebuttal of that evidence after the process of the cross examination conducted by the counsel for the defendant on the witnesses of the plaintiff side and after the exhibition of the document, any objection that could have been raised, that it would be examined by the court. But in this very process, it is to be seen that if somebody is also, in addition to the oral testimony of 2, 3, 4 witnesses, also relying upon some documentary evidence, so that documentary evidence process has been provided under section 70, article 71 deals with oral evidence. But because according in and that guidance has been provided in the initial article 2, very important, very fact-in issue has been discussed, and that state of mind, mental condition, किसी भी अमर के साबित करने के लिए किसी भी चीज के बारे में वो फिर आगे उसको कनेक्ट करती है विद रेलेवेंसी ऑफ फैक्ट्स. और कौन कौन से जैसे सर्कमस्टेंशियल एविडेंस होती है, जैसे टेस्ट ऑफ आइडेंटिफिकेशन पीरियड होती है, दैट इज आल्सो वन ऑफ द सर्कमस्टेंशियल एविडेंस बिकॉज द ऑकरेंस हैज नॉट बीन सीन बाय एनीबॉडी एंड एट सम लेटर पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम सम अक्यूज्ड हैव बीन अरेस्टेड एंड इट हैज आल्सो डिस्कवर्ड दैट बिकॉज द फीचर्स वर रेफर्ड बाय द विटनेसेस that they had seen the A while committing the murder of B, but since he had fled away from the spot and it was a daytime occurrence, it was a broad daylight, and A was armed with the pistol, and C and D are deposing in the court, but they are not furnishing their ocular account of the occurrence, but they are furnishing, they are deposing in the court as after the arrest of the accused, and this aspect of the matter I have discussed in the light of a judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court of Pakistan. That is also available on my YouTube channel with the title Shnakht Parade ki Shahadat ke Gawah ki Ahmiyat since Supreme Court ke faisle ki roshni. कुछ अर्सा पहले ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उसको बड़ी एक अथॉरिटेटिव जजमेंट हैंडल किया. इसमें यह क्या है कि जो मैजिस्ट्रेट आइडेंटिफिकेशन परेड के प्रोसेस से गुजरते हैं वो जेल में घर जाना है, उसे आइसोलेट करके रखना है, फिर वो 9-10 एक ही जैसे डमीज के साथ खड़ा करना है, और इज अन नोन एंड देल बी दे गैंड दे दैट दे शैल नॉट बी एक्सपोज बाई दी पुलिस, दे शैल ऑल्सो टेक वेरी कॉशनरी एंड प्री कॉशनरी मेजर्स सो दैट दे शुड नॉट बी एक्सपोज टू दी विटनेस, बट देन दे विटनेस एंड एंड दे बी mixed up with those dummies, and then they'll turn by turn, if there are two or three witnesses who had seen those stranger and unknown accused at the time of commission of offense. But this is certainly the test of the senses and memory of the witness that it has been held. And initially that judgment was rendered by the Honorable Law High Court probably in 1989, and then again 1-2 years back that I have discussed. So likewise, if there is a normally, you know, hearsay evidence is inadmissible piece of evidence, but there is an exception has been created under the law in case of dying declaration, or there are many other circumstances which have been narrated under Article 46 and its some subsection. We'll discuss it as well. It is relatable to if somebody made any disclosure, the foremost to keep in view the sanctity of the testimony of a dying declaration means a person who is at the verge of death, as he had sustained critical injuries on his vital parts and he was hospitalized for 2-3 days. Firstly, he remained unconscious, but after some treatment, he regained his consciousness. And then it would proper satisfaction shall be made through the doctor that will certainly put some questions to that critical injured person, the victim. But he, if he is expected to die, and even if, let's say, if he, while he was in a proper senses, he was in a position to use his understanding, and he was in a condition to give reply of some questions, and the police officer who was investigating the case had recorded a statement in Section 161 CRPC during the course of investigation while he was in under condition, but subsequently he died. It means that statement in Section 161 CRPC shall also can be considered a dying declaration. And then the evidence, normally the testimony of the police officer is inadmissible in evidence. You know, let's say somebody says if their confession is made before the police officer, it is not admissible piece of evidence. Except, you know, for that very, some exceptions have been created under Section 162, subsection probably 3, only for the purpose of the confrontation. If that witness has resiled from that his former statement, that previous statement which was recorded under Section 161 CRPC before the police during the course of examination, it would be a different scenario. Then it, and that relevant portion shall be mentioned. But at that time, you said so. Indeed, during the course of investigation, in your statement, now you are making a different statement. So this normally it happens. Sometimes let's say the witnesses are won over by the accused party. So they retract from their statement. So like similarly, because this is a kind of now circumstantial evidence, as I have. When I recall my memory, I'm referring a case when I was a practicing lawyer back in 2001 probably. I conducted a trial, just to give you a brief, very brief reference. An occurrence took place in district courts of some city, and primarily the accused there were as many as 3 assailants. They were armed with sophisticated weapons like 7mm and Kalashnikov. And at 9 a.m., just when the, you know, that those courts were had just opened, so they went there, they were chasing the person who later on became the complainant of that occurrence. And in that very gruesome and brutal occurrence in the premises of a kachari, it is let me recall, because on 14th of November 1995, I may forget, or just click to my mind, that attack was launched in the chamber of the lawyer, that lawyer was killed, another taxi driver with whom that complainant arrived, and another person, three or four persons were murdered. Fortunately, that complainant just through, you know, flying kiss like injuries on his forehead. Anyhow, he got registered the case. But due to the hue and cry and the, you know, the sensitivity of that location of the occurrence, because it was a, you know, kachari lawyers community, there was an outburst and outrage, and three police of three different nearby police stations. When the three accused persons fled away from that spot, they were chased and police encounter took place. There were four assailants. One was killed in the police encounter. There, just within 30-40 minutes of that original occurrence. But at since I was representing the on behalf of widow of one taxi driver, so that's when I was conducting trial. The witnesses, not much time had lapsed. It took 6 years, and that then anti-terrorism court was had tried that case. And they became hostile, disowned the whole story, that complained of the eyewitness and injured, as well as two other witnesses. Oh, what was the story behind? In fact, that complainant was himself accused in the murder of the father of the principal accused, of one of the accused persons who had committed the murder of three persons, including one lawyer in the kachari. But I obtained the certified copies and prior in time, and at the time of final argument, anyhow, during the cross examination, I put those certified copies, because the three deceased persons in which that star witness complainant had deposed in the court and were not his relatives, not his brother, not his uncle or father. They were just strangers for him. But unfortunately, they were not having any enmity with the accused party. But in that very matter, when I started, finally argued the case, I still remember, I said, Jai sir, sir, I know I don't have the case as it was originally, you know, registered and during the whole police investigation. It was certainly a case of ocular account, but that has washed away. They have totally denied since they had denied. That's why I had to conduct the cross examination upon those witnesses, because of their changing stance, when they had disowned the original story. And I had referred certain those certified copies of previous enmity in which they have entered into compromise. That complainant being accused in that murder case of one of the accused, father of the accused person, they have and entered into some compromise. So certainly they were watching, you know, you scratch my back, I scratch your back. You will watch my interest, I'll watch your interest. And even otherwise, with the passage of time, the situation happens. Normally it happens. Because even the very nearer and dearer one do enter into compromise when the gravity of that occurrence diminishes and come to the minimal level after, you know, when somebody is in a very emotional and charged, when something has happened, some cruelty has taken place, but with the present. So I said, I initiated my argument, but sir, I have got a case of very strong circumstantial evidence. Now, it is not the case of direct oral evidence. Well, those witnesses had resided. Then I narrated that ordeal, how the occurrence took place, and how the three innocent persons who were having no concern whatsoever with the complainant of the case, rather they were just, you know, very innocent, and no enmity and no motive on that lawyer. But this is the, let me salute to the police, who immediately responded, reacted, chased the accused person after the occurrence. They got hold of them. One was killed in that police encounter, one of the assailants, and these three were arrested. Their weapons were recovered, and due to recovery of those weapons, separate FIRs were chalked out under section 13 of the Spencer Arms Ordinance. So the court was so convinced because of, and I established very strongly that chain of events means which gave rise to prove the factum of the fact of the occurrence, despite that eventuality of turning hostile of the star witnesses, and they were awarded death penalty. I don't know if still the appeal is pending or not. So since I had already referred in my earlier lecture, so the dying declaration we were referring, this is the kind of circumstantial evidence. This is hearsay evidence, but it becomes relevant in that particular situation. Likewise, that I have referred, identification paid and the judgment of the Supreme Court, that is also available on my. So there are some situations the evidence can take a different turn. So further we'll carry on with probably one or two more lectures on Kanune Shahad Order 1984, and let me make you remind and understand. Firstly, you have to become a competent trial lawyer. Don't, you know, if somebody are preferring to remain within this profession as a practicing lawyer, this is a wonderful profession. But you need to put on labor, you must be industrious. Firstly, at initial stages, you know, for 4 or 5 years, don't depend on, there can be other modes of earning. You may teach in the college, but I had practiced in the initial stages. I was also teaching in law colleges. I was earning reasonably. I was legal advisor of a department for 4 years. But as the, you know, practice grew with the passage of time, one can set his priorities. No harm in it. But you must, all the laws, criminal law, civil law, or whatever you are preferring, but at the, I believe that the initial years of the practice, you must try to grasp all fields of law, be it civil law, be it criminal law, be it other specialized law, and particularly, please kindly, I want to make you a very humble request, like my younger brother and sister, like sons and daughters, because I am doing it, frankly speaking, just as a public service, and it is my passion, and one should never, you know, create any sort of restriction and clogs on one's heart felt, you know, sort of passion. That is why I request you, be a trial lawyer. You may not be having it. Some people say we don't have the brief. But kindly, if your senior has the brief, kindly watch him. Even if your serious senior is not having the case, particularly the murder case or cases of serious offences, as far as you know, criminal cases are concerned, you may visit the court. You can sit. Nobody would stop you. And if some evidence is being recorded, cross-examination is being conducted, final arguments are being advanced by the learned counsel for the parties, have your notebook, take the notes, learn from every stage, and read thoroughly, again and again. Even give focus and emphasis on even the word fact in issue, relevant facts. So then we will later lectures will be discussing oral evidence, documentary evidence, expert evidence, and the evidence of the character of one person become relevant. It is not relevant in civil cases, but it is relevant in criminal cases. If some particular plea is taken, then we'll be discussing the examination chief, cross-examination and re-examination. And there are some other special provisions. Thank you very much. I believe much time has been consumed by me today, but maybe it is not digestible to my learned friends, but my purpose and objective is to share legal knowledge and to fulfill my thirst of this passion of public speaking. Thank you very much.